Laudetur Jesus Christus. Welcome to Vatican Radio's continuing coverage of the 31st World Youth Day. I'm Mary Shovlin here with Roberta Macaroni at the controls, and we're going to bring you this very last leg of Pope Francis's trip here in Krakow. We're inside the Tauron Center just before heading to the airport. Pope Francis is here. He's going to meet with the young volunteers. The arena is full of them. Some 20,000 volunteers that have worked so hard over the past few years to make this World Youth Day a success. Before Pope Francis's arrival on the stage, we'd like to welcome all of our listeners today, especially from ESNE-TV, Radio Maria in the Philippines, Telecare TV, CBS News, Shalom World Television, Salt and Light TV, EWTN-TV, Radio Maria, Telecare TV, Net Television, and Catholic TV. And from wherever you're joining us today, maybe it's on our Vatican player, welcome and thank you for being with us. This should just only last a short 45 minutes or so. The Holy Father on his way. He's left the Archbishop's residence, packed his bags, and he made a surprise visit from the window. He's been addressing people, as we know, from the window of the Archbishop's residence in the evenings. That's a tradition that goes back, of course, to Pope John Paul II. And so he did so as a surprise to the thousands of pilgrims that joined outside the window, said, hoping that he would come out, and he did. And he just basically said, thank you very much. Thank you for your warm welcome all of these days. And said, before leaving, I wanted to give you all my blessing. But he also asked them, as Pope Francis normally does, to pray for him and to pray together to the Virgin Mary, each one in their own language. So he led them all in the praying of the Hail Mary in their native tongue. So just a little surprise visit, the Pope of surprises, before he leaves Krakow. And what a nice way to end, by thanking all of these volunteers, some 20,000 plus that have worked hard, not just this week, and they've come from all over the globe. They've worked tirelessly over these past 2 or 3 years for every World Youth Day event, whether it have been in Krakow or around the world. Let's just look at some of the things that these wonderful volunteers were in charge of. They just, even this past week, they were in charge of information at the railway stations, trams and bus stops, the airports. They're working in the press center. They're providing translations. They helped with the general organization and all the logistics, working day and night, thanklessly, usually, probably tired and exhausted as we speak, but you could never tell that. They are just so excited to be able to say goodbye and thank you to Pope Francis for having come here among them. So what we know, this is how the rundown of the next 45 minutes should be. The Pope will arrive here on the stage. He will be greeted by the organizing committee, Bishop Damian Muscus, who will greet the Holy Father on behalf of all the volunteers. Then we're going to hear from two of the volunteers, one from Poland and one from Panama, which of course we heard today. The Holy Father announced that the next World Youth Day would be in Central America, in Panama. So we're going to hear from one of the volunteers from there. Then we'll hear Pope Francis, who's going to address the young people. And then he'll meet personally with the organizing committee and some of the benefactors who have helped make all this possible. Then he heads to the airport. All of the World Youth Day pilgrims certainly sad to see him go. And the whole nation of Poland certainly wishes him well. And he'll be greeted there by the president of Poland, Andrzej Duda, and the First Lady, and before the Holy Father with his delegation boards the plane, hopefully getting a nice meal and some well-deserved rest on his way back to Rome. Just a short 2-hour flight back to the Eternal City, where he should land around 8:30 local time. So an intense week, a long week, takes lots of preparation, but it went by in the blink of an eye. These young people see surely forever changed as we see them holding up signs of the Divine Mercy image, signs of Pier Giorgio Frassati, the patron saint of these World Youth Days, and many more. So got some music, and we're just waiting for the arrival of Pope Francis as we begin the very last moments of this World Youth Day here live from Krakow. We're live at the Tauron Center here in Krakow. Pope Francis should be here any moment on his way to the airport. He's going to come by here to say thank you to the organizing committee, to the volunteers, to all of those who make this such a great success. We hear the young people cheering. And we're going to hear from one of the young volunteers who's from Panama. And the Holy Father just announced today that the next birthday would be in Panama, the first time it's being held in Central America. So a lot to look forward to 3 years from now in 2019. So I'm sure on social media or on the internet there are already websites dedicated through the Archdiocese there. In Panama 2019. They're asking us if we're ready. We're ready to meet Pope Francis. Pope Francis should be there any moment. We know that he stopped briefly to speak outside of the window at the Archbishop's residence before getting in the car to come over here to the Tauron Center. So we expect him any moment, and we're going to hear from the bishop who is in charge of the World Youth Day Organizing Committee. A lot of work. We're going to hear from Bishop Moskos, who's also the auxiliary bishop here in Krakow. Two volunteers, one from Poland, one from Panama. We'll also hear from Pope Francis, and then he'll make his way to the airport where he'll board a flight of Polish Airlines. As we know, the Holy Father, when he leaves Italy, takes Alitalia. When he comes home, he takes an airline of the hosting country. So he'll be heading here. He is Pope Francis. We'll let you listen to his warm welcome by the young people. Pope Francis riding around in a small electronic cart through the Tauron Arena here. Surrounding him are some of the 20,000 volunteers that have worked so hard to make World Youth Day a success. And it's nice that they get to be this close to him. It's so nice that he's going so slow among them, because they've been often on the outskirts of these celebrations helping pilgrims. And so this is their moment with Pope Francis. Everyone armed with an iPhone or a smartphone or an iPad, something. Everyone getting a glimpse. One of the most social media-friendly World Youth Days ever, as we have all these new instruments of social media, and it was definitely a World Youth Day that was lived out on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram and Snapchat. And so even though thousands couldn't be here, they felt like they were part of the celebrations. Ojcze, Polish for Abba, Father. Ojcze being the Polish word for father. Greeting there, Holy Father. We see, again, some of the flags from all over the world. I'm sure we'll see a Panamanian flag as we start to look forward to World Youth Day 2019 in Panama. We see next to Pope Francis, Cardinal Jewicz, the Archbishop of Krakow, longtime friend and personal secretary and aide to now Saint John Paul II. No one knew him like Cardinal Jivich did, and what a wonderful legacy and gift he's given to his good friend Saint John Paul II by having such a successful World Youth Day here in Krakow, the very land of Saint John Paul II. Look at those faces. Those are the legacy of John Paul II's World Youth Days. The beautiful image of Our Lady of Kalwadia, Zebrzydowska. This is an image that John Paul II would often pray in front of as a young boy and then as a priest and a bishop. Holy Father venerating some relics that have been brought here, a reliquary, venerating them with a kiss. Somebody holding up a sign, saying, Papa, call me, with their phone number, because he has been known to call the faithful throughout the world. He's not afraid to pick up the phone and say hello, and no one ever believes it's him on the other end.
Amen.
Holy Father, beginning this meeting in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Umiłowany Ojcze Święty.
We're hearing from Bishop Damian Muskus, OFM, Franciscan. He's Auxiliary Bishop of Krakow, and he is the Coordinator General of World Youth Day in Krakow. Beloved Holy Father, he says, look at the smiling faces of these young people. Are they tired? Surely. But are they happy? No doubt.
Mówią nie, ale są zmęczeni. Ale czy są szczęśliwi? Móc przedstawić Tobie, Ojcze Święty, tysiące młodych świadków miłosierdzia, którzy
He asks, are they tired? Surely. Are they happy? No doubt. Holy Father, presenting these thousands of young witnesses to mercy who serve the pilgrims day and night, attentive to their every need, sensitive, full of enthusiasm, and always available to help. It is one of the best moments of these unforgettable days. They already know that to love is to serve. They have already tasted what it is to fall in love with Jesus and see Him in our brothers, alone, discouraged, sad, and poor. Here in Krakow, they have experienced the power of divine mercy and want to go further to serve, to be instruments of the merciful Lord in the world, asking for love. Young friends, you are the hope for this world. The young kids here breaking into the bishop's speech, chanting Papa Francesco, Pope Francis. I don't think they're going to let him make his plane this evening. Again, we're listening to Bishop Damian Muskus. He's the coordinator of all of these volunteers for World Youth Day in Krakow.
Jest z nami tutaj Matka Boża z Kalwarii Zebrzydowskiej.
With us here is the image of Our Lady of Kalwaria Zebrzydowska.
To nie jest kopia, to jest cudowny obraz, który przybył na spotkanie z papieżem Franciszkiem
this
i z wami.
Is a copy. This is not a copy. It is truly the miraculous image.
To ona wychowywała małego Karola Wojtyłę,
it was she
który później stał się
who educated the young Karol Wojtyła, who later became Pope John Paul II.
A jako kapłan i biskup jej powierzał.
As a boy, he visited this image as a pilgrim and as a priest and bishop, entrusted to her the difficulties of the church of which he was pastor. Following in his footsteps, the World Youth Day Polish volunteers and the entire committee of World Youth Day would go as pilgrims to Kalwaria to put in the safe hands of Mary the Great World Youth Meeting Initiative. It was the volunteers that invited her to Krakow for the great celebration of faith so that she would be here, because we wanted her maternal presence and protection here. We entrust to her their young hearts, full of love for Jesus and a desire to serve others. We entrust to her the world where they will soon be returning to. May it become better and more beautiful thanks to their youthful testimony of their meeting with the merciful Lord.
Ojcze Święty, dziękujemy Ci za wielkie.
Let us entrust you to Mary's protection as well, Holy Father, and all of the worldly anxieties that weigh on your heart. Holy Father, we thank you for the great message of hope and love that you have brought us. Thanks for the witness of faith and trust in divine mercy. We wish to become the program of our lives. Thank you for your joy, your humility, and your witness, the witness of your life, and to us above all, for us and for the young people, it's very important. Thank you. We'll see you in Panama. These are the greeting in Polish by Bishop Damian Muskus, who's Franciscan, OFM. And he was the one in charge of coordinating all of these volunteers. Again, that's Our Lady of Kalwaria Zebrzydowska, this
Miłowany
image.
Ojcze Święty.
It is the original image.
W imieniu Departamentu Wolontariatu i wszystkich wolontariuszy, tych obecnych tu, w tym miejscu, ale jeszcze pełniących dyżury na Campus Misericordie, witam serdecznie.
I greet all of the volunteers. Not all of them are present here. Some are still out working in the Campus Misericordie. There's another young Polish priest.
Dali swoje ręce, oczy i uszy, aby zapaleni ogniem miłosierdzia przez Ciebie, Ojcze Święty, zanieść go tym, do których zostali posłani jako wolontariusze. Teraz chcieliby złożyć świadectwo, jak przeżyli ten czas służby wolontariackiej.
These young volunteers will now be at the service of mercy.
Michał, brat Macieja, który zmarł, jako ten, który
the first testimony that we're going to hear.
Miasta, wiele grafik I filmów.
Dimiku Cieślak, who is the brother of the young man who designed the graphics for the World Youth Day, who passed away.
Miały być kolejne zwykłe Światowe Dni Młodzieży, a się okazało, że ta wielka radość, która może przysłonić wielkie sprawy, jednym tylko zdaniem została na chwilę wstrzymana I za to dziękujemy. Maciek miał być tutaj, kolejny dowód na to, że był na to gotowy. Tekst, który przygotował I chciał wygłosić w waszej obecności.
Again, this is the witness of the brother of the young man who passed away. He's reading the testimony of Maciek that he had prepared. He was supposed to give his own witness here today, and he passed away on July 2nd, and he's reading what he had written. I am sick, he says, with cancer. And I found out that my cells
W niespełna dwa tygodnie po świętach Bożego Narodzenia okazało się, że ta odmiana
that I have a cancer that is difficult to be healed from. I don't have a great chance of survival of this cancer. And I discovered that this cancer this cancer really seems to like me because it's spreading everywhere. And for the first time, I heard from the doctors.
Te pół roku diametralnie zmieniło moje życie. Jeszcze w grudniu stałbym przed wami o własnych siłach I o dwóch nogach. Niestety, te
During this, these past six months, these past 6 months have totally changed my life because 6 months ago, I could have been here standing among you, but at this point, I've already lost one leg. I never would have imagined my life without bike riding or chocolate, and now I'm in a wheelchair and I'm doing chemotherapy. This cancer is attacking me. Before all of you, I want to thank my colleagues on the organizing committee for World Youth Day. I want to greet all of them.
And
the doctors of the cancer center here in Kraków who are fighting my cancer, I thank you
for
each mass and prayer that you offer for me.
Doskonale zdaję sobie sprawę, że nie mogę żądać od Boga cudu, ale bardzo Go o Niego teraz proszę I błagam. Jedna z napotkanych osób kiedyś zapytała mnie, jakie jest moje największe marzenie.
Someone asked me,
dotarło do mnie, jak szybko.
What is my biggest dream, my greatest dream?
Wielu z nas marzy o wielkich karierach, dużej rodzinie, wielkim majątku, sławie, awansie,
we dream of a family.
Ja od pół roku jednak mam jedno marzenie.
Chciałbym po prostu having money, etc. But I only have one dream. For the last 6 months, I've had only one dream.
Móc powiedzieć, że już wszystko okej.
I would like to meet you at World Youth Day.
Każdy dzień jest piękny.
And I
jednak nie zawsze w natłoku obowiązków.
I hope that all of you know how to rejoice in life, to have joy in life. But we can't often see how happy we are, and we have to know how to appreciate it. We have to learn how to appreciate the joy in life. And I hope that you can understand. I hope you can understand this without going through what I have gone through. This is the letter from Maciek, who was the graphic designer for these wonderful banners and posters that we've been seeing all week. He died on July 2nd and should have been up here giving his own testimony here in person. But this was his brother reading it from his iPad, where he had written it before passing. His brother, Michał.
Świadectwo wolontariusza z Polski wygłosi Marzen.
This is Marzen, a young Polish volunteer.
Jestem z Polski i od ponad roku pracuję w komitecie organizacyjnym Światowych Dni Młodzieży.
She's saying, I am Polish and I participated on the organizing committee for World Youth Day.
Co zawdzięczam Światowym Dniom Młodzieży? Jaki to miało wpływ na moje życie?
I want to talk to you about what I owe to World Youth Days and how it has influenced my life.
Skłoniło mnie pragnienie odnalezienia swojego miejsca w kościele. Zaczęło się, gdy byłam w gimnazjum.
It was the desire to find once more my place in the church that led me to participate in World Youth Day. It all started in high school when I realized that very few people were taking part in the youth masses. I thought that the young people do not want to join or do not find their place in the church. Later, I came across a television program about World Youth Day with the Pope, and I felt the desire to go there too, because so many people were there and I wanted to find my place in the church. Now I am at my third World Youth Day. I went to Madrid, Rio, and Krakow.
Co zawdzięczam temu doświadczeniu? Każde uczestnictwo w Światowych Dniach Młodzieży uczyło mnie ufać.
What has changed with me because of World Youth Day? What do I owe this experience? Well, each time I have learned to have confidence and trust in God. In the 5 years between Madrid and Krakow, I had a great experience of God's mercy. In Rio, I learned of God's care even in the small things. And I said to myself, if God takes care of the small things with such detail, He will take care of the big ones as well.
Do tej pory pamiętam Twoje spotkanie, papieżu Franciszku, z wolontariuszami w Rio de Janeiro. Wtedy stałam pośród tysiąca.
She's explaining what she found, that's something extra that she found in World Youth Day. She said, I found my place in church and in life. I still remember the last meeting of Pope Francis with the volunteers in Rio. I was among the thousands of volunteers and I asked myself what I wanted to do with my life. Then the Pope said, fear not. Maybe not everyone even knows what to do in life, which way to go, and how to find answers to many questions that preoccupy the young. Just ask Jesus, pray, and entrust everything to Him. He will give you the answer. One thing is certain, God has a plan for each one of us. Then I felt peace, joy, and confidence. This is true. Following that, I spent a year abroad. It was a difficult period because in the end, I found myself far away from the community, the church, and often without the sacraments. Only then did I realize what the church is and how difficult it is to live well without it. The experience of community in the Eucharist and prayer lived in the World Youth Days with millions of young people around the world. And the period abroad gave me the confidence and belief that I cannot live without the church. Through these experiences, I thought that I could never move away entirely from the church. However, despite this, I could not decide to return to Poland, but the Lord found a way with a job offer to be a volunteer for World Youth Day. As soon as I heard this, I bought a ticket, packed my bags, and returned to Krakow. My return was not just a return to the country, but a return to the church. Today, instead of me,
Także Światowe Dni Młodzieży w Rio były naprawdę początkiem takiego mojego powierzania się Bogu.
Today, instead of me, you were supposed to hear a testimony from Maciek, our graphic designer, but on July 2nd, the Lord called him to himself.
Dostałam wspaniałą możliwość pracy w komitecie, co było głównym powodem powrotu do Polski. Odnalazłam swoje miejsce w kościele. Rozwinęły się relacje z poprzednich Światowych Dni Młodzieży.
Wanting to express in a few words what impact World Youth Day has had on my life, I'd say, after the World Youth Day in Madrid, I learned English. After the one in Rio, I slowly learned to trust God. Between the World Youth Day in Rio and that of Krakow, I had the wonderful opportunity to work with the preparatory committee and therefore to return to Poland. I'm gradually finding my place in the church. What I can say is that God fulfills our dreams. And today, and I can safely say without any doubt that I am happy in the church and that we are helping to form in the church that we are all helping to form and in which God is present every day, especially in the Eucharist.
Y ahora aquí, en Polonia, yo quiero servir siempre, siempre a la Iglesia. Papa Francisco, rezo por usted.
In Spanish, she's saying, thank you for coming to Krakow, and I pray for you. Rezo por usted. It's a young Polish volunteer. And the last couple of lines of her discourse, she said in Spanish for the Holy Father.
Zapraszam Krystiana, aby skierował do nas słowo jako ten, który
now we'll hear from another volunteer.
Jest reprezentantem Panamy.
Christian Gregorio Ruiz Luque from Panama. The crowd chanting Panama, Panama, getting excited for 2019.
El Señor ha estado grande con nosotros y estamos alegres.
The Lord has done great things for us.
Querido Santo Padre,
dear Holy Father Francis, good evening.
Tanto querer armar lío para el Señor, según usted mismo nos lo pidió en Río de Janeiro.
Christian is saying, so much trouble I wanted to create for the Lord as you asked us to do in Rio. And now, see the trouble I've gotten into? I have to give a testimony in front of the Pope. My name is Christian Gregorio Ruiz Luque from Panama. I was born in Chitre, which is a province of Herrera. I'm a son of Crispulo Ruiz Cayar and Josefina Virginia Luque Fuentes. I'm happily married to Ana Cecilia Rodriguez Tepada. I'm a candidate for the permanent diaconate in my country, which I am preparing for. God has blessed me a lot by giving me the opportunity of participating in every World Youth Day since the one in Toronto in 2002. Within that blessing is the fact of having served as a volunteer on those occasions, including this one in Krakow. Because of my past World Youth Days, especially the one in Rio de Janeiro, I came here ready and prepared to be a more dynamic volunteer, to work in various sectors, helping to make the kits or helping pilgrims with transportation issues, all this together with my wife, with whom I'm sharing this World Youth Day as a volunteer for the first time. But God in His infinite wisdom gave me an easier and less complicated task. First, helping in the selection and packing of the pilgrim kits, and then welcoming everyone by giving documents to pilgrims and volunteers who assisted at the catechesis and other events in the Tauron Arena. At the same time, helping the Sisters of Life in their task of guiding all the priests and their assistants during the distribution of communion. Being a volunteer for World Youth Day has been and is a way to transmit a little bit of the mercy of God to those who are asked to help through being a pilgrim, a local citizen, or volunteer. Even though this job can be difficult sometimes, trying the patience and faith of the volunteers, in the end, by remembering that it is Jesus whom you are serving, this becomes such an impact that without warning, the volunteer changes his life, the life of those he is helping, and also the environment in which he is working. In short, serving as a volunteer is a way of growing in holiness, exercising mercy. But as you give, so shall you receive the gratitude of pilgrims, improving your abilities and growing in virtue. Pope Francis, from the bottom of my heart, I take from this World Youth Day each and every experience that I shared with my volunteer brothers and sisters, with my wife and my fellow countrymen, other volunteers or pilgrims that were here and followed us on social media. And it is my wish that when I return to my country, God allows me to keep serving through my job and in pastoral work, so I can be a true disciple and missionary, living the joy of the gospel, praising the Lord. And I can work for the next World Youth Day in my country, in Panama.
Cuente con que el espíritu de servicio que aquí nos congrega, mis coterráneos y yo trabajaremos con la diligencia que solo el Espíritu Santo y el amparo de Santa María de la Antigua, nuestra patrona, nos puede inspirar para hacer de este evento uno que nos acerque todos los participantes a Jesús. Desde ahora, siéntase bienvenido a nuestra bella Padre Ismeña. Muchas gracias, querido Papa Francisco.
He's saying he's going to entrust the upcoming World Youth Day in his country to Our Lady, the patron of his country. And he says, I hope that Panama will be ready and with an open heart to receive you in 2019. This young volunteer, Christian Gregorio Ruiz Luque from Panama, giving him a t-shirt already. Hashtag Panama. The t-shirts are ready to go. And in the end, we had three beautiful testimonies. One was unexpected, that of Maciek, who passed away on July 2nd, his brother reading his own testimony from his iPad. Then we heard from the young Polish volunteer and now young Christian from Panama, who's visiting with Pope Francis, and gave him a t-shirt, hashtag Panama. Young people breaking out into spontaneous cheers. And now it's time to hear from the man himself, Pope Francis.
Carissimi volontari.
Dear volunteers.
Prima di fare il ritorno a Roma, sento il desiderio di incontrarvi. E soprattutto
before returning to Rome, I wanted to meet you and to thank each of you for your commitment, generosity, and dedication in guiding, helping, and serving the thousands of young pilgrims. Thank you, too, for your witness of faith, that together with that of so many young people from every part of the world is a great sign of hope for the church and for the world. By giving of yourselves for love of Christ, you have experienced the beauty of commitment to a noble cause. You have also seen, he goes, I don't know if my speech is nice or not. It's 5 pages. It's 5 pages long.
Un poco aburrido.
A little bit much.
Lo consegno.
He goes, Pope Francis is saying he's going to just leave the discourse here. He's not going to read from the script, which he says 5 pages long. He's going to hand it over for the young people to have. And he just wants to speak from the heart.
Pero me dicen que yo puedo hablar.
They said he can speak.
En cualquier lengua. En cualquier lengua. Porque todos tienen traductor. ¿Sí?
He goes, do you want a translation? I think I would. He's just asking their confirmation if they were going to let him speak in Spanish.
Esto, preparar una jornada de la juventud es toda una aventura.
This World Youth Day has been an adventure. Una aventura.
Y llegar, servir, trabajar, hacer.
To work, to serve.
Y después despedirse.
And afterwards.
Primero la aventura, la generosidad.
To rest.
Yo les quiero agradecer a ustedes.
Generosity. Thank you for being yourselves. Thank you to all the volunteers and the benefactors. To everyone involved.
Quiero agradecer las horas de oración que han hecho.
And all of the hours of prayer that it took for this to be a success.
Con mucho trabajo, pero mucha oración.
It did take a lot of work, but also a lot of prayer. And thanks to all of you volunteers who dedicated so much time to prayer so that we could have a successful World Youth Day.
Gracias a los sacerdotes.
Thanks to all the priests.
A los sacerdotes que los acompañaron.
That accompanied you here.
Gracias a las religiosas.
Thanks to all the religious men and women, religious and all the consecrated people who came with you. And thanks to all of you.
Se metieron en esta aventura.
All of you who participated in this adventure with hope and energy. The bishop, during his presentation,
les dijo un, no sé si van a entender la palabra, un piropo. ¿Entendieron?
Said a word.
Les dijo un cumplido.
I'm sorry, I didn't understand the word.
Ustedes son la esperanza del futuro.
You are the hope for the future.
Y es verdad.
And that's true.
Pero con dos condiciones.
But with some conditions.
¿Quieren ser esperanza para el futuro o no?
Do you want to be the hope for the future or not? Yes.
Con dos condiciones.
And so here are some conditions for that.
No, no hay que pagar la entrada. No, no.
No, you don't have to pay. You don't have to pay the entrance to get in. That's the first thing.
Tener memoria.
Is to remember.
De dónde vengo.
Remember where
memoria
I come from.
De mi pueblo, memoria de mi familia.
To have present the memory of my people, of my family, my history.
Testimonio de la segunda voluntaria.
The testimony of the second volunteer was full of memory, was full of remembrance.
Memoria de un camino andado.
A memory of her journey that
memoria
she has passed through.
De mis mayores.
The memory we have received from those older than us.
Un joven desmemoriado.
A young person without memory is not a hope for the future. Is that clear?
Padre, ¿y cómo hago para tener memoria?
But how do we conserve our memory?
Habla con tus padres, habla con los mayores.
Speak to your parents,
sobre todo,
speak to your grandparents.
Habla con tus abuelos.
Speak to your grandparents above all, is that clear?
De tal manera que si vos querés ser esperanza del futuro,
so if you want to be the hope for the future,
la antorcha de tu abuelo y de tu abuela.
You need to receive the torch which is being passed from your grandparents. They need to pass that torch to you. Are you going to promise me that? You're going to promise me that you're going
Panama.
To prepare for Panama
Van a hablar más con los abuelos.
To, by speaking to your grandparents
si los
more?
Abuelos ya se fueron al cielo, van a hablar con los ancianos.
And if your grandparents have already gone to heaven, go speak with other elderly people.
Y les van a preguntar,
go and ask them.
Pregúntenle. Son la sabiduría de un pueblo.
To know the wisdom and the history of a people, that's the first condition to be the hope for the future. So remember, to remember. You are the hope for the future, the bishop said. Here's the second condition now.
Para el futuro soy esperanza, y del pasado tengo memoria, me queda el presente. ¿Qué tengo que ser en el presente? Tener coraje.
I need to be courageous. If I'm going to have the memory of where I've come from, then that will help me live the present. And in order to live the present, I have to be courageous.
No asustarse. Escuchamos el testimonio.
We heard in the witness given.
Despedida. Testimonio, despedida. De este compañero nuestro. A quien el cáncer.
Who. We heard the testimony of Maciek, and he's here with us, but your courage,
ese joven hoy no está acá, pero ese joven sembró esperanza para el futuro. Entonces, para el presente, coraje.
So for the present, we need to have courage.
Valentía, coraje.
Courage. Claro. We must have courage to live the present.
Entonces, si tienen, ¿qué era lo primero?
The first one, what was the first one again? Memory.
Si tienen, van a ser la esperanza. ¿Está clarito todo?
Then we'll have hope for the future. So if we have memory for our past, memory of our past, courage for the present, we'll have hope for the future. Is that clear?
Yo no sé.
He said, I don't know
si voy a estar en Panamá, pero les puedo
if you're going to be in Panama,
que Pedro va a estar en Panamá.
That Peter, he goes, I don't know if I'll
Pedro
be there, but I can tell you
preguntar.
Peter will be there, the successor of St. Peter. And for him to be there, go speak to your grandparents, go to your parents, have the courage to face situations of the present, and you will be hope. And then you can go respond to Peter. That God bless you all very much. Thank you for everything. Pope Francis concluding. And off the cuff, a spontaneous speech with the volunteers who have worked so hard here during the World Youth Day. 20,000 plus. Now, Pope Francis says, each one in your own language, I'd like you to pray with me, to pray to the Virgin Mary, Our Lady here. Our Lady to Kalvaria Zebrzydowska.
Y les pido que recen por mí, no se olviden, y les doy la bendición. Que los bendiga Dios Todopoderoso.
Pope Francis now
el Padre,
blessing.
Y el Hijo. Y el Espíritu Santo. Ay, me olvidaba. ¿Cómo era?
Memoria. He's asking him to repeat. Memoria. Coraggio e futuro. Courage in the future. We see the World Youth Day cross there next to the image of Our Lady. Again, this image that these very volunteers would go pray to and the organizing committee. Our Lady of Kalvaria Zebrzydowska, which was also so dear to John Paul II.
Yeah.
Pope Francis greeting some members of the organizing committee. He put aside his prepared remarks and he started them and then just handed them over to the members of the organizing committee, saying, I'm going to leave these here with the bishop. And if you don't mind, he said, I'll talk to you in Spanish. He asked their permission, said, do you mind if I speak to you in Spanish? Is that okay? And he did. He encouraged them to keep the memory of their past. And he said, if you don't know your past, you won't be able to be the hope for the future of the church. And he said, in order to do that, you need to talk to your parents. You need to talk to your grandparents. And he said that this weekend as well, during World Youth Day, he encouraged everyone to speak to their grandparents. He said, they'll have stories that will move your hearts. And because the grandparents and those who have gone before us, they know the history of your people. They know the history of your family. They know your own history. So he said to do that, and he wanted us to have courage for the present. So memory of the past, courage for the present, and hope for the future. He said, if you do all of those things, he said, I don't know that I'll be in Panama, you know, God willing. He said, but Peter will be there, the successor of Peter, of course. And he said, as you prepare in these three ways, by having memory, having courage, and having hope for the future, then you'll be ready for World Youth Day in Panama. Pope Francis is now set to meet members of the organizing committee and the benefactors who gave so generously to make sure that World Youth Day could happen. And it took the hard work, blood, sweat, and tears of these 20,000 plus volunteers who have come from all over the world. And because of the hard work that they do, volunteers are able to save a little money on the costs that it takes to participate in World Youth Day. We, some of the people, the Holy Father now greeting on the way out, also getting a special rosary from Pope Francis. A lot of them trying to get a selfie as well. We've seen that a lot. Pope Francis now turning back to the crowd, waving a big wave of goodbye to the young people. He's supposed to be at the airport in about 15 plus minutes. He's supposed to be there around 6:15 p.m. local time, and the plane is supposed to take off around 6:30 p.m. So we hope that he definitely is able to take off on time. That way he'll get back to Rome on time around 8:30 local time. We'll leave you with these images here from the Tauron Arena, where Pope Francis has just left and thanked the many volunteers. He's thanking the organizing committee and the benefactors. Then he will drive over to the airport, where the president of Poland and the first lady will be waiting for him before he boards his flight heading back to Rome. I'm Mary Shevlin again on behalf of all of us here at Vatican Radio and Vatican TV. Stay tuned. We'll offer you commentary from the airport as well. Thank you all for joining us. We'll come back very soon with our commentary as World Youth Day 31 comes to a close.
błogosławieni, miłosierni, albowiem oni miłosierdzia dostali.
Wielkie brawa dla papieża Franciszka.
Brawo!
Papa Francesco! Papa Francesco! Papa Francesco! Papa Francesco! Papa Francesco! Papa Francesco!
Pan kiedyś stanął nad brzegiem, szukał